Hello, and welcome to this demonstration of Agilent eSoft's ICECAP 2006. In this demo, we will introduce you to what's new in ICECAP 2006 and show you the features in this latest release that can reduce your overall device modeling efforts. Our goal is to give you a glimpse into why many of our users consider ICECAP 2006 to be the biggest features and capabilities release ever. Let's start in on what's new with the 2006 release. In 2006, there are three main features that we'll be focusing on. The biggest of the new features is Multiplot Studio. Multiplot Studio is a new user-friendly and convenient analysis environment that makes it easier to visualize data and access frequently used functions. And overall, it makes it easier to cipher large amounts of congested plot data. Next feature is the new BSIM 4.5 Model Extraction Toolkit. This toolkit supports the latest installment of the Compact Modeling Council's BSIM 4 model. The toolkit has a new user interface and a smarter extraction flow. As a result, the module provides more insight into the extraction for a more efficient process. In conjunction with the new graphics features, you now have the ability to greatly reduce your overall extraction time. The last area of features are the new computer operating system platforms and the improved data loading performance. ICECAP 2006 is the first time for supporting the Linux platform and the Windows XP platforms. In the area of data loading, there has been a huge 5x improvement overall. Let's first take a closer look at Multiplot Studio. As I mentioned previously, this new valuable feature will benefit all ICECAP users. Here's an example directly from the new features example files from within ICECAP 2006. We'll first view Multiplot Studio at the individual plot level. The first thing you've probably noticed are the five icons on the right side of the plot. These are the new area tools. The first is the PO or Plot Optimizer. When the icon is highlighted, this activates the plot. At this point, you can do a right mouse click to bring up the menu to choose the Plot Optimizer. When the Plot Optimizer comes up, you'll notice that the optimizer is already configured for your plot. This feature can be extremely handy if you need to optimize on a particular portion of your plot, such as this example. If you change your mind, everything can easily be reversed. The A or Autoscale icon allows you to toggle the Autoscale function on and off. Each time you choose the icon, the plots are automatically redisplayed. The last icon in the upper right is the E or Error Calculation icon. This allows you to toggle between relative and absolute errors directly on each plot. Notice that the error information is conveniently displayed at the bottom of each plot. Now for the two icons at the bottom right, labeled X and Y, these icons allow you to change the plot layout quickly to view plots with different types of axes. As you click on the icons, they will toggle through the default linear to log to DB, just with a simple click. Since plot interpretation can be a little confusing, we have made it easy to change the plot options with quick right mouse clicks and choosing plot options. To clear up this plot, we'll choose a second color for the curves and have the plot drawn with different colors for a second order curves. If I turn on the legends function with the right mouse click, I can gather even more information from the plot. Going one step further, I can gather marker information by selecting points on the curves and reading the measured or simulated information across the top of the plot. As you see, we can quickly untangle information hidden in a confusing plot. ICECAP now has the capability to place multiple plots in a single window. I will now open a plot that has been created and configured with three different plot styles. Depending on your needs, this could have easily been configured with plots of the same style. When plots are combined into a single window, you still have independent control over each plot with the area tools and other features. For the more advanced user, customized GUIs that perform special functions can be attached to the window. Here's the same plot as before, but with a push-button GUI added to the multi-plot window. You've just seen the first key feature of the 2006 release that will allow you to shave time off your extraction process. We'll now move on to the next feature, the new BSIM4 toolkit. The new BSIM4 toolkit has several new improvements for the standardized BSIM4 model. The first is that the toolkit now supports the latest version of the model, BSIM 4.5. Second, the release has a new facelift with a new and efficient interface. I'll take a moment to describe the structure of the BSIM4 toolkit. The toolkit is broken down into two components, each having two subcomponents. By design, the two main components are the measurement module and the extraction module. Each main component has two subcomponents, one DC and one RF. This structure allows you to separate the measurements from the extractions and the DC from the RF if necessary. All are fully integrated into a common extraction. To highlight the toolkit features, I'll show the DC extraction portion of the toolkit. This is the new interface for the extraction module. It has a convenient left-to-right flow through the tabs and a top-to-bottom flow within each tab. In the extraction flow is a suggested extraction. Each step then displays the selected steps and the available steps for the extraction. If there is an order that suits your process better, you can move the steps up and down in the flow. Moving over the extraction flow portion of the interface, you see an E, O, or T preceding each step. These stand for direct extraction, predefined optimizer, and predefined manual tuner. Here's an example of a predefined optimizer. The BSIM toolkit gets its strength from the direct extraction functions. By doing the direct extraction, there's little optimization that needs to be performed. This smart extraction philosophy has demonstrated a 40% reduction in customer processes. Simply put, a foundry that takes 20 days to complete a full process extraction can complete the same task in 12 days or less. The BSIM toolkit is not the only place we've been able to increase speed. In 2006, we have reduced the number of redundant processes and improved the data loading capabilities that have allowed us to improve the raw speed of ICECAP. This is a comparison of the data loading speeds of the current ICECAP 2006 versus the previous ICECAP 2004 release. The 2006 release also sees the introduction of the Linux platform for the first time. When the Linux version is paired with the ADS linear and transient simulators, you can see that this pair produces a fast platform simulator combination, especially when compared to other popular configurations. This brings us to the end of this presentation of What's New in ICECAP 2006. Now that you've had a chance to see the new features, we think you'll agree that ICECAP 2006 is a device modeling tool that will help you be more efficient and accurate with your modeling efforts. We encourage you to take ICECAP 2006 for a test drive so you can experience firsthand why this is the